Hey guys, this is Naveen here. Welcome back to Naveen Automation Labs. A very quick video on Gatling once again. So far, we have seen how to use get call and a post call. But today we are going to talk about how to use a put call. It means if you really want to update a specific entity, or let's say specific user, in that case, you can hit the put call. So for example, let's see, we are going to simple take one basic example, put update over here. And we want to update this particular user. It got updated. We will get the response code as 200, and this is the service URL, but this is a put call, right? So we have to send this particular JSON payload along with the request. So what I'm going to do, that I have already created one update user.json over here, that is under resources bodies. I have already created, and the way we have created the add user.json that we have already used that in the previous video, same thing, update user that I have created over here like that. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create one simulation class, and this time let's see, I simple write, this is my update user simulation, whatever the name you want to give, and this is again extending simulation class. Okay, let me just import that from here. Okay, and along with that we need to import, as we know, we need to import two more packages. So let me just quickly import these two packages. Now in this particular class, what I'm going to do, that same thing, we have to create first our HTTP configuration. So I simply create one variable, that is my HTTP configuration variable, which is equal to HTTP dot, and we have to use the base URL. My base URL is HTTP colon double slash request res dot in. That is what the URL I'm going to use, and I'm putting a slash over here as well. And then if you have any header, if you really want to create your request with the header, so let's see, this will accept, I simply say that content request as application JSON. So this is the request, and then I want to add one more header that I want to pass the content type also, or if you have any other authentication header, if you really want to pass that also, you can pass it in this particular section if you have more headers over here. So I simply write application slash JSON like that. So this is the accept content type, is header, and everything is ready. Then what I'm going to do, that I'm going to create a scenario. So the way we have created earlier, I'm just going to copy paste. So let's say I simply create a scenario over here, so that like this, till here I'm going to copy. Okay, so I'll simply go to this, and the scenario is giving a scenario name. Let's see, update user scenario, and execute this. I simply write update a specific user that I want to update, and then what kind of request it is after execute, it is a dot put call we have to use. Instead of post call, we have to use a put call. And then in the put call, what is the service URL? So I simply write put call double slash double quotes API slash user. Let me just see this. This is a put call, API user slash two. So user slash two. Two is the user ID over here that you can pass it like that. And then along with that, if you have any header, no, we header we have already mentioned over here. And then we have to pass the body. So simple write body. And the body, we have to take it from the JSON file. So you have to use a raw file body method you have to use, and you have to pass the path over here, the file path over here. I simply write it is available under my src test resources under bodies, and then whatever the JSON file that you are using, update user.json file. You can see that update user.json, and this is the exact same file path you have to pass. Dot src forward slash src means in this particular project, go to src test resources bodies, update user.json file is available like that. Okay, and then after that you have to convert that as JSON. So there is a method as JSON, you have to use that, and that's it. I just want to verify dot check, I want to verify that the status dot in, and I want to give a range. Let's see, I simply say that it's 200 to 201 like this. Let's see, I have given that, and yep, this is the thing that we have added. And let me just put a bracket done, and then I have to create one setup method, and we have to inject this particular scenario dot inject. And I simple write at once user only one right now, and then dot protocols. My protocol is HTTP configuration protocol that we have already created, and then simple run it. So this protocol will be executed, and let's see. So I'm going to run this particular engine, and then we are going to run this particular simulator. So update user simulation, it should be picked. So the number of update user simulation is number 3. So I simple enter number 3 over here, press 3, and simple write a description. Let's see, update user, and then started executing this this particular simulation, and almost done. There are no failures, everything is working fine. And this is the index.html file got generated. So I simple copy this, simple open this path in a new tab in your browser, and see this request is absolutely working fine. In the details, update a specific user, you can see that absolutely working fine. Okay, like that. Later on, if you want to increase the load, you can do that. So right now we are just, guys, in Gatling, we are just back-to-back calling for different types of APIs you are calling it. If you really want to use a dot delete, you can simply write dot a delete method over here like that. So that delete, guys, you can try by your own. Otherwise, I will create a separate video on that. You can pick this particular API. There is a delete, and we don't need to pass any JSON payload. Simple call this API, you should get 204. So you just simple write dot delete and then get user. If you really want to do that, let me just right now I can do it right away for you guys. I simple write dot execute method. Sorry. I simple create one more execute method and execute what? HTTP. I'm going to give a request name, and let's see, delete a specific user or delete user, and then I simple write dot a delete method over here. So one second. Yeah. I simple write dot a delete, and for delete, what is the service URL that you want to use? So for delete, I just simply click on it. Same thing, API users forward slash 2. I want to delete the same user. So I simple write API forward slash 2. And first of all, we have to remove this from here. Otherwise, this API will not work. Might not work because we have already given the forward slash over here. Okay, but earlier it got work, so that's okay. But safer side, I'm going to remove this forward slash from here, and API users 2, and that's it. That we don't need to pass any JSON payload for that. And I simple write dot check method, and I'm going to check the status. The status dot is what? If the data is deleted, I should get 204 response code. So let's see, I'm getting 204 or not. Or better, I'll write the status in within the range. I'm going to write that between 200 to 204. Let's see, I should get. Okay, and here I can write within 200 to 210, and then that's it. So this is a scenario got added over here, right? So I have two scenarios, guys. One is for put call, and then one is for delete call. And in between that, I'm going to put a pause. If you really want to use a pause over here, the pause of, let's see, 3000 or 3 seconds, I'm going to write it. That's it. So between two calls. So let me just remove this. I simple say that, yeah, this is first we are calling what? First updating the user, and this is the deleting the user. This is the second call, deleting the user. Okay, and then we are injecting this particular scenario over here. So we have one single scenario, guys. I'm not creating two scenarios separately for update and delete. Let's see, this is update, and I rename. We can rename also if you want. That's okay if you really want to refact and rename. So update and delete user, I will write it so that you will understand better. And then simple click on refactor. Okay. Now let's pick this particular scenario and let's run it. So let me first remove the console, clear all, and right click on engine and run the engine. It should pick update and delete. That is number 3. And I simple write simple test scenario. What are the description that you want to give? And started executing, pausing for 3000 milliseconds. And great, absolutely working fine. And this is the index.html file got generated. Let me just open that. I'll just replace this HTML file path. Awesome. And you can see the result over here. One is for update user and one is for delete the user. Both are absolutely working fine. You go to the detail section, update user in green color with one request, delete user with one request, absolutely working fine. Okay, so like this, you can simple call all the respective get, post, put, and delete. This is simple, really good, guys. Just like rest assured or HTTP client, you can do your functional testing also with the one single user. So it will do the functional testing as well as the performance testing. The same functional test cases can be converted into your performance test cases as well. Like that also, you can simple do that. Right now, I'm not doing any performance testing over here exactly because we are running with the one single user. Right now, we are just checking all the syntaxes and all the features which are available with respect to different HTTP calls. So this is a put call. This is a delete call. Get call, we have already seen that get user with the dot get method in the previous videos that we have already seen that, and the add user also we have already seen that. So please practice all these four HTTP request methods and let me know if you have any issues with that. Till then, take care, subscribe to the channel, let me know if you have any issues. God bless you all, guys.